Driver. And now, Alongside P. Webster, I'm Mike Murphy. The opening faceoff is moments ago. We drop it a bit early here today, shortly before 7 o'clock at the Whittemore Center. Wildcats against the Sacred Heart Pioneers. And UNH will be moving left to right here in the opening period as Jason Salvaggio carries across the Sacred Heart line. His wrist shot is denied by the netminder for the Pioneers to our right, and that is Nathan Perry, a junior from Bath, Ontario. Puck being battled for along the half wall. Left wing corner is Vella, and Vella lost it as Barliant brings it out to Jasper, and it's pushed forward for Sacred Heart. We're a minute into this one. Wildcats and Pioneers, non-conference battle here from Durham tonight. Puck ends up under the glove of Danny Taroni. A chance for us to have our keys to the game brought to you by Sullivan Tire and Auto Service.
I think the number one key tonight is, you got a flow on last week, last Saturday's game, is the third line's matchup. Patrick Grasso is the right wing on that third line. So that's going to be a key matchup. Number two, banging in the crease, getting the Wildcats' big bodies out there in front of the Sacred Heart goal is going to be a key. And number three, can Danny sparkle this weekend like he did last weekend? That's Danny Taroni in the net for the Wildcats.
Those keys of the game presented by Sullivan Tire and Auto Service. We're always here to get you there. Visit SullivanTire.com to learn more. Our uniform report brought to you by Collins Sports Center in Rochester, the official screen printer and embroiderer of your UNH Wildcats.
Now the Wildcats wearing their home whites with blue piping and blue shorts, blue pants rather, and blue helmets. And the visiting Sacred Heart Pioneers with those bright crimson red uniforms. And, they're not crimson actually, a bright red and white highlights.
Quite the contrast, red against white here today in the uniform report brought to you by Collins Sports Center in Rochester, the official screen printer and embroiderer of the UNH Wildcats. Check out their website, collinsports.net, or call 603-335-1417. Speak with a team sports specialist. No score here, 2 minutes in. Here comes Patrick Grasso into the Sacred Heart zone. Just before he could get on net, Mitch Nyland, the Sacred Heart captain, able to step aside and deny a shot on net.
Yeah, Nyland had an angle there. Grasso had a little bit of an opening, but he couldn't get on his toes for that acceleration.
Wildcats started their top line. Michael McNicholas centering Tyler Kelleher and Jason Salvaggio. Matias Cleland and Cameron Marks on the blue line. And Danny Taroni in net. Sacred Heart went with Evan Jasper, Justin Danforth, and Vito Bavaro, their top line to start. Mitch Nyland, Liam Clare, the defenseman, and Nathan Perry in goal. More on him in a few moments. We're at 17:15 to go in the first period. Shot flipped from the high slot, blocked by Blackburn, and it comes out to center ice. And that's where it's picked up by Barliant. Barliant comes in, his wrister snaps off the end wall, ends up on the right-hand side. Both Dawson and Miller on the back check for the Wildcats. It comes over to Van Riemsdyk. Chanter, his diagonal feed, gets it to Fragona. Coming into the zone, Justin Fragona, the freshman from Mississauga. Had a wrist shot blocked away into the right corner. Miller there, touch pass to Fragona into the circle. Brings it back to the point, Marks. He'll flip one out that's smacked away on the stick hand by the netminder, Perry. Kept in by Cleland. It wraps behind the net and over to scoop it up from there is Minello. Sacred Heart gets gummed up along the wall on the near side. Unable to get out of the zone as Wildcats have somebody pressing down there. Jamie Hill joins the play. I think it's Miller stuck against the wall and he's finally peeled off and the puck comes out. As Hansen gets there for Sacred Heart, he'll dump in and head to the bench for a change. Cleland comes near side to Marks, and the Wildcats look to break out along the near boards. It bounces off Jamie Hill and skedaddles to center ice. Cleland gets there first and puts a shot on net from the red line, and this will be held by Perry for a faceoff. Speaking of Perry, let's get our Between the Pipes report, which is brought to you today by Serve Pro of Dover Rochester.
Sure, for the Sacred Heart Pioneers, they have Nathan Perry in net, the junior out of Bath, Ontario. Comes in this year, having played in two games and a 4.69 goals against average. And for the Wildcats, Danny Taroni in net, the junior out of Trumbull, Connecticut. Having picked up both wins last weekend in five games played, he's 3-2 with a 2.84 goals against average.
Your Between the Pipes report brought to you by Serve Pro of Dover Rochester. Serve Pro, damage restoration like it never even happened. Visit servepro-dover-rochester.com to learn more. Puck batted at center. And Sacred Heart comes in offside with 15:54 to go in a scoreless first period. This is Wildcat Hockey from Learfield. 15.5 to go in the first period. The Wildcats about to go on a unitil power play. Tarone skated over to the bench trying to get an extra attacker in, but a hooking call against Sacred Heart has the Cats a man up with 15:32 to go in this opening period.
Oh, we played four minutes and 28 seconds of a 5-on-5. Here we go into the specialty situations with Corey Kennedy picking up the 2-minute penalty for hooking.
Coach Jamili said his team has to figure out how to score 5-on-5, and I said not necessarily, because there will be a lot of times where somebody's off, and right now it's a Unitil power play, Unitil energy for life, a chance to strike first. Wise hold to the point. Here's a slapper from Vela. That got blocked before it could reach Perry. And Sacred Heart comes out 2-on-2. Across the line, McElmurray wraps all the way behind the net. Feeds in front, was looking for Danforth, but Danforth taken off the play. The net has come off. It's pegs, but play is continuing. Wildcats control. Nazarian at center ice gives to Vela, and Vela bumps into a hit from Nyland. And Sacred Heart the other way. The net still off its moorings, and finally a whistle blows. Tarone had his hands up wondering when they would stop play for him.
Well, the referee down in that corner where the Wildcats skate out onto the ice, he tried to put the net back on. They wanted to let the play go forward, Wildcats on the power play, so they thought they were going to get it down into the zone. They were never able to, and the referee only got to one peg. Coming back the other way, the linesman noticed it. Then we got to blow the whistle here. And I give him credit of trying to keep the flow of the game going if the Wildcats have the offensive thrust. But the Wildcats had that turnover at the Sacred Heart blue line.
So UNH has to deal with a faceoff in its own zone. Grasso wins the draw. On the near side, it's Kelleher. Still a minute 20 of power play time. No score. 14:50 to go, first period. Salvaggio into the zone. Tries to drop it back, and it's swiped away and cleared down the ice. Tarone comes out to play it to Cleland. He'll wrap it around. Comes McNicholas at the Wildcat line near the bench. Over to Kelleher. Kelleher accelerates into the zone 1-on-3. His pass for Grasso just out of his reach, and it's cleared out by Ruslan Rakhmatov. Cleland goes to get it off the end boards, gives to Blackburn. McNicholas goes across the direct capital blue line. Sidesteps Ehrlich Dirksen behind the net. Grasso comes over to join McNicholas. Grasso has it left corner. Up the wall, Kelleher with 38 seconds of power play left. Cleland at the point. Right wing, McNicholas. Straight away, Cleland. Left side, Kelleher. Touch pass, Salvaggio. Fanned on the shot. And then it's lifted out of the zone by Christian Lloyd.
Yeah, the Wildcats trying to work it to the center mid-slot area for Salvaggio. It was in his skates and didn't get it at the right angle for his forehand.
Jeff Carroll, meanwhile, on the forecheck, has the puck in the Wildcat zone before losing it along the boards. Eiserman has it. Does take some precious time off the power play, down to 10 seconds. Eiserman gives to Nazarian in the Sacred Heart zone. He weaves between two defenders. On the backhand shot, got blocked by Eiserman. His rebound attempt goes behind the net, and that's where Claire tries to push him off the play. Sacred Heart back at full strength. It's Marks, right point. Holds there, tries to throw it in front, but it was blocked away as it hit Jordan Minello's stick, and it comes out to the far end. And now the Pioneers the other way. Carrying into the zone, the backhand feed, Corey Kennedy, who just came out of the box, was trying to center for Minello. Out to the near side, Zach Sekos. In the corner, both Marks and Eiserman battle for it. Goes to the far side, there's Dylan Maller, senior defenseman. He gets tripped up, but still able to deliver a pass behind the blue line. Marks, long outlet feed, hits Nazarian. Nazarian across the line, left wing. Goes behind the defender, backhand shot, stick save, Perry. Good move by Ara Nazarian.
And he was at the end of his shift, too, with tired legs, and he did that.
No score, 12:45 to go. Minello comes in. He flicks one that goes wide off the far post. Van Riemsdyk takes the carom down the ice. Across the line, works it for Blackburn. Pass skipped over his stick, though. Blackburn, though, takes it away from Minello. Down to Van Riemsdyk. Now Grasso, backhand shot, save, and a big one by Nathan Perry, who covers up for a faceoff with 12:40 left in this scoreless first period. Wildcats and Sacred Heart. This is Wildcat Hockey from Learfield. 12-10 to go, first period, no score. Grassota, Blackburn, the freshman coming to the Sacred Heart line. Wrist shot wide. Van Riemsdyk plays it in front. Grasso, his shot blocked. As coming in front was Rakhmatov. He goes across the way, and Barlind has to chase it down to the far corner. Van Riemsdyk looking to strip it away. Miller pinches in just outside the zone. And Van Riemsdyk will tap it to the Sacred Heart end, and sliding down to his duff was Dirksen, and this gives Miller a chance to pounce. Miller looking to play it in front of the cross pass for Fregona, gets sent right back to the right wing. Fregona into the corner, Miller. Miller spins away from the defense, gets to the bottom of the circle, cross ice pass, couldn't be handled by Maller. Here comes Cleland, his slap shot gets blocked and sent back out to center. Marks the feed to Fregona. Fregona back in the Sacred Heart zone as they're in the middle of the switch. Back to Miller. Forehand shot save. Rebound loose. Goes right through the crease. Fregona was down there. Went right through the blue paint. Laterally and never did go on net. Jamie Hill, though, gets dumped to the ice. And now it leads to a break for Sacred Heart. Shot from the right wing by Nick Lotito gets deflected out of play with 11:05 to go and no score.
Wow, what action by the Wildcats. Hill down there in the mix. Fregona, Miller, wow, what a line there. They're turning out to be pretty exciting themselves here in the early going of this contest, but they just can't find the right angle. It slides through the crease a couple of times. Once it went past the post and then went straight across parallel to the goal line.
Wildcats have outshot the Pioneers 7-0 here, 9 minutes into the first period, but no score yet. Anthony Wise in the scrum along the far boards. Puck comes out to Salvaggio at center. He's got Kelleher to his right, but he'll just dump it in and chase after it as he goes around Clare. Runs into Nyland. Salvaggio still struggles for it in the far side. McNicholas looks to keep in, but it's back out to the red line. And that's where Dylan Maller will back it up to his own zone. Over to Wise. And Wise's pass from McNicholas just out of his reach. Gets all the way to Perry, who slows it down with his paddle. Grabowski on the near side, skates in front of his own bench, tries a long diagonal pass, broken up by Dawson, who gives to McNicholas. McNicholas gains the zone, left wing. He comes back to Kelleher, has it on his forehand in the faceoff circle, but lost control, and it's dumped out by the Pioneers. And this will be an icing call with 10:13 to go in the first period. No score.
So your Wildcat pride with the official debit card of the UNH Wildcats. Open a service credit union checking account at any branch, including their newest location right here in Wildcat Stadium, or I should say there, across the street in Wildcat Stadium.
Now, that'll be quiet this week. There's a lot of stuff going on in Wildcat country, but football not one. It's a bye week for Coach Sean McDonald and his team. They're home against Albany next Saturday at noon. Off the faceoff, Dylan Chanter tried to throw one in front. Eiserman's there looking for a rebound. Nazarian comes up with it, tried to turn the corner on the left, but it was taken aside, now lifted to Kennedy. Kennedy has a chance. He rushes in from the right side. Poke check at the last instant by Dylan Chanter. Terrific play by Chanter to get his stick in there and stop a rush. Pass comes from Eiserman to Vella. Vella across the line right wing side, but he runs right into the wall of Christian Lloyd. Out at center ice, it's Carroll. Carroll tries to go in one-on-two against the Cats. Marks will check it away. Over to Eiserman, who plays it forward to Vella. Vella's got some room to operate. Goes into the Sacred Heart zone right wing. Into the corner, takes a check from Lloyd, but maintains possession of the puck. Dumps it deeper in on the cycle to Nazarian, out of his reach and behind the Pioneer cage. Over to the right side, Rakhmatov gets out of the zone, and now Sacred Heart, 2-on-2 opportunity. Coming into the Wildcat zone, wrist shot saved, Tironi. There's the first bid for the Pioneers as it was triggered from the right side by Rakhmatov. He controls behind the goal line to Tironi's right before having it dislodged, and over to Grasso. Grasso, the rookie of the month nationally. A four-goal game last time the Wildcats played here at the Witt. A 6-2 victory against Merrimack on Saturday night. Speaking of Saturday at the Witt, get your tickets now. Tomorrow night, Mercyhurst is in for a 7 o'clock game. Tickets available at unhwildcats.com. Here we're scoreless, 8:45 to go in the first. Wildcats and Sacred Heart meeting for the first time. Pass from Grasso leads Blackburn into the zone. Blackburn gets to the middle. Forehand shot, save. It's loose to the right side of Perry, who made a terrific stop. No rebound could materialize near the net, but the Wildcats still possess in the Sacred Heart zone. Wise throws one in front. Glove save by Perry.
Yeah, that's the third line for the Wildcats, buzzing all over the place again. Liam Blackburn, nice cutback to go into the slot and ended up on the far side. Perry stuck with him. Nice job by that freshman line.
New Hampshire nothing, Sacred Heart nothing. 8:26 remaining in the first. This is Wildcat Hockey from Learfield. .edu/analytics and prepare yourself for one of the world's most in-demand careers. Under 8 minutes left in the first, Wildcats have applied pressure yet to break through in the scoreless contest. Hill, Fragona, and Miller, that fourth line out there. Cleveland and Marks cheat up front as well. Danforth breaks it out to center ice for Sacred Heart, only to be denied at the UNH line. It's Marks moving it to Miller. Miller into the zone. Forehand shot wide. And the carom goes all the way down the ice. Cleveland will hustle back. Stops dead in his tracks right behind Tarone. And begins the march. Up the left side. The feed to McNicholas. Uses the boards to find Salvaggio. Chips it forward. And then goes after Claire. Claire will backhand it deeper in the Sacred Heart end. Comes out near side to Grabowski. Grabowski goes diagonal to the right-hand corner. It's an icing, though, as he was outside the red line when he sent it in.
Yeah, that was one of the first times that Sacred Heart have been able to effectively get out of their own end with basically two touches of the puck. But an errant clearing pass. You got to make sure you get the red line out at center ice. And it's going to come all the way down to the Sacred Heart end for a face-off to the goaltender's left. Cats first line out there with Chanter and Matt Dawson.
The draw goes into the corner. It's won by Sacred Heart as Clark leaves it on the near side. Welcome back inside the Whittemore Center. Mike Murphy, P. Webster, no score. UNH and Sacred Heart. 16 seconds into the second period and still a minute 23 left in the Wildcat. Unitil power play, Unitil energy for life. Salvaggio out of the faceoff in the New Hampshire zone, gets the puck down the Sacred Heart and to our left. He and Claire meet in the corner. Grassel there as well. Salvaggio plays it forward to McNicholas, back out to the point, Kelleher. He switches with Cleland, who has it in the high slot. Throws one in front, it's knocked down and then handled by Nathan Perry, who's done a really good job, Pete, here between the pipes for the Pioneers.
Yeah, he was able to see through that screen, although it was the diminutive Patrick Grasso providing that screen. Well, Wildcats here with their second power play of the evening. You know, actually, Mike, 5 out of the 9 goals scored by Hockey East teams here tonight, the first period, have been power play goals.
Trend of the times.
Yep.
Kelleher along the left half wall. Drops it down to Grasso. Now back out high, Cleland. McNicholas on the right wing. Cleland in the slot. Left side, Grasso holds to the bottom of the circle. Back to Cleland. Slap shot goes wide. 45 seconds remaining on the power play. Cat set up in the zone. Cleland at the point. Hands off to Kelleher, left side. Puts it in the forehand. Dodges a defender. That was Sekos. Then they had it poked away on the stick by Rakhmatov. Over to Kelleher again. Goes across the ice. Here's a quick shot, McNicholas. And that one is handled and held by Perry.
That was strange. Perry seemed way out of position, or was the net was off the peg. And I think that may have been why the whistle blew and why he was standing at such an awkward angle.
Very nonchalant.
Yeah.
And you're right, the net again coming off its peg. That's been just too frequent here on the left side. Nazarian will take the faceoff of the Wildcats. Puck still right in the faceoff dot. Vela digs it out to Eiserman off the end boards. Played around to the far side, and Sacred Heart clears it. Peroni plays off the carom. Has to dodge the on-charging Colton Hansen. Works it to Wise. Wise, diagonal feed Maller. Maller gives it to Vela, who then plays it behind the net. Perry slows it down. Final seconds tick off in the penalty against Butcher. And he's out of the box. We're back to 5-on-5 hockey. Sacred Heart kills off UNH's second power play. No score. 18:15 left in the second period. Nazarian along the right wing boards. Got sandwiched between a couple of Pioneers, lost the puck. It's out at center ice where Maller will go retreat into his own end. Deals it to Wise, near side, the pass along the boards, Eiserman. Eiserman gains the line, looking to center to Vela. That's knocked off his stick by Butcher, back to center ice. And here comes Carroll. Carroll, forehand shot, save Peroni. Crashing into the boards was Chanter, hit by Carroll. Butcher has it near the kickboards, behind the net. Wraps to the right wing wall. Claire drops it to the point. Kennedy holds there. Now veers towards the point before giving to Clark. Clark goes laterally right to left across the way. Here's a shot from the point. That's deflected wide. That was fired in by the Spencer Grabowski. And the Wildcats get to center ice. Vela gets wrapped up by McElmurray, and there'll be a whistle with 17:19 to go in this scoreless second period.
Well, the Wildcats just getting out of the flow, and Sacred Heart picking up some loose change in the Wildcat end. And that kind of started by a little Wildcat turnover just inside the UNH blue line. Wildcats need to make sure they get the puck deep, get past that first layer of defense there right at the blue line, make their defensemen turn around.
Claire off the faceoff looking for Danforth. He fans on the shot. Here's one tipped right through the crease. Taroni was sprawled. But the puck ends up behind the net. Big opportunity for Sacred Heart there. There was a wide open net in the puck that was in the blue paint. Claire keeps in the zone. Backhand shot, Taroni save, covers up on the bid that came from the mid slot from Justin Danforth. And then some extracurricular activity after the whistle.
I'm going to say that opportunity just 10 seconds ago, Mike, that you said went through the crease. It did go through the crease, but I think it might have gotten a piece of the pipe right down along the ice. Gonna get a chance to see a little bit on the replay there. No, that was the second bid there. Shot to Danny Taroni covered up.
Face off to Taroni's left. Puck being kicked around. Cleland wins it over to Marks. And the Cats will break out with Grasso. Grasso across the right line. Gets right to the Sacred Heart line. That's where he loses possession. And Butcher plays it back to the Wildcat head. Marks has to settle a bouncing puck.
That's that first layer of defense right there just over the blue line. Sacred Heart is stopping the Cats on.
Marks will dump it in. Goes behind the net where Lloyd goes after it. Blackburn and Grasso on the forecheck. On the far side, Rakhmatov tries to play it. Grasso, though, continues the persistence, as does Blackburn, who gives to Grasso, wraps around to the near side. Cleland, quick wrist shot save, and it goes out of play as the paddle of Perry kicks it out to the net with 16-17 to go in the second period. No score.
Yeah, there you go, the third line of the Wildcats. One of my keys to the game. They get out there with the big body of Van Riemsdyk and the craftiness of Blackburn and Patrick Grasso, who has a nose for everything out there, doing some damage against the Pioneers, but not able to break puck through Nathan Perry.
Kennedy wins this faceoff in his own zone, so Sacred Heart has it along the near side. And they turn it over, though. Steal by Hill. Hill looking for Fragona, but just a little bit of a hip check denies that chance as Hansen got in there to slow it down.
That's a senior back-checking Jeff Carroll, saving the Wildcats from having a great opportunity.
Now Carroll has it behind the New Hampshire net. He tried to play it in front for Kennedy, but it was struck right back, so Kennedy forced to go to the half wall before he curls towards the middle. Loses it in the slot. Maller has it. Long head man feed to Hill. Hill gives ahead to Fragona. Fragona back to Hill. Wrist shot save. Jamie Hill from the right circle fired one in, aiming for the five hole, but Nathan Perry true to the task.
Yeah, it turned out to be a two-on-one, but a little veer off the straight path by Hill turned it into an opportunity only for the drop pass, and he did get it. Perfect straight-on blast, but, well, Perry's up to the task. Kid comes in only with an 86.5% save percentage. Stopped all 15 already here tonight.
Off the faceoff, puck comes out of the Wildcats end. Vito Bovaro trying to go around Cleland. And it's turned over to Kelleher. Cats have it 2-on-2. Kelleher joined by Salvaggio comes across the left wing line. Leaves for Cleveland. He'll put a quick wrister that goes wide. Marks gets to it, keeps in right point. He'll throw one in, and there's another save for Perry.
Yeah, he lines up perfectly with the net out to the right point where Cam Marks fires it in, and Perry stops it with a belly. No rebound.
Perry just seems to be gaining more and more confidence with each additional save he makes.
Yeah, Wildcats got to break through this, so they're going to be holding their sticks a little bit tighter as we get going. Still got 5 minutes to go before we get to the midpoint of this game.
All right, off the faceoff, it's Kelleher going behind the net to the near side left. Blew a tire as he tried to spin away from Letito. Still controls, though. Gives to Savage. Turns in his forehand. Shot goes wide as he didn't have a good handle on it. And the Pioneers clear to center ice. Marks back to his own line. Gives to McNicholas. Nice centering Pete Salvaggio. Bounces past him and Kelleher. And on it is Hansen for Sacred Heart. Hansen comes into the zone. Walking in a backhand attempt is, oh, well, there's a big crash too as Grabowski came in, ran right through Tironi. That'll lead to a penalty. It leads to a scrum as well. Wildcats will go on a Unitil power play when we return to the Wit. 14:45 left in the second. UNH and Sacred Heart scoreless. This is Wildcat Hockey from Learfield. Well, Danny Tironi standing tall, and that's good news, but better news is who's in the penalty box, Spencer Grabowski for Sacred Heart.
Yes, that's going to be another power play for the Wildcats here. They're third this evening. Some of the Sacred Heart players skating over to their bench. You can see them kind of mouthing it. How did we get a penalty for that? The goalie was out of the crease. He just went for a shot, tried to skate by, but referees protecting the goalies.
5:15, the time of the penalty, a Unitil power play, Unitil energy for life. Although off the faceoff, a shorthanded opportunity. Danforth, backhand shot, save, Danny Tironi! Oh, what a beautiful save as Danforth and Jasper were on the rush. And it's still scoreless with 14.5 remaining in the second period. Sacred Heart possessing in its own zone. It's Danforth again trying to gain the line. And he gets tied up, and that'll end this power play, won't it?
Yeah, Aaron Nazarian doing the back check. And well, the Sacred Heart player was wheeling the puck through the center zone, and Arrowhead just had a little too much of his stick wrapped around. Boy, what a save by Tirone, and I think it got a piece of the post again. We see an overhead shot of that. Oh, my. God, right off his start in the faceoff, a two-on-one break for Sacred Heart. And then you get a little sloppy with your skating, and you're forced into a tough back-checking situation, and you take a penalty. The Wildcats need a little more of a spark.
First penalty against the Wildcats. It comes just 24 seconds into what was a power play, so now it's 4-on-4 hockey. Cleland will carry out of his own zone, looking for Grasso, too far on the feed. So back to his own line, Rakhmatov for Sacred Heart. 6 minutes in to the second period. This penalty against Nazarian, the first of the night against UNH. Into the Wildcat zone, Sakos. Defended by Cleland, tries to stuff in near post, comes through, Sakos missed on a backhand feed from the far side after Tirone was prone following his first save.
Oh, I don't know how Sakos missed that one. It was wide open on the backhand side, the second opportunity on the far side.
So sigh of relief from the Wildcat faithful. Marks slows it down to the zone end and then hands off to Kelleher. Kelleher does just the opposite. He speeds up. He gets tripped up going into the Sacred Heart zone, a delayed penalty coming up. And so we're having the penalty start to add up. Third in the last minute, 24 seconds.
Yeah, that was a little sloppiness by Sacred Heart. They didn't have the wheels moving. Got caught reaching, and the Wildcats wheeling and dealing with the puck. Tyler Kelleher's got those nifty moves. Yeah, it's a guy who probably should have given Sacred Heart a 1-0 lead. Sikos is going to sit down.
So 4-3 for the next 35 seconds. Cats win the faceoff in the Sacred Heart zone on another unit tilt power play, trying to break the scoreless deadlock in the second period. Cleland, right circle Kelleher on the forehand. Down to McNicholas, back to Kelleher. His shot, that gets tipped wide, hits off the glass. And the ricochet gets it out to Claire. Claire will send out to the Wildcat end. McNicholas over to it, curls towards the middle. 10 seconds left on the initial penalty against Grabowski. And we'll be back on even strength. Kelleher at the top of the right circle. Near side, Cleland. Down low, Salvaggio. Back to Cleland, slap shot. That one is blocked down and then pushed forward on the part of Kennedy. So the first penalty against Sacred Heart is over. We're back to 4-on-4. For about 10 more seconds, and the Wildcats will have another power play as it comes back to the UNH end. 12:25 remaining, second period, no score. Wildcats and Sacred Heart Pioneers. All right, Wildcats back at full strength, back on the power play here. 5-4 as Sakos is in the box for another 55 seconds or so. Jeff Carroll comes into the Wildcat end, right side, backhand shot, that sails far and wide. Marks has it. Marks along the far boards, makes the pass to Vella, but he's in too soon.
Yeah, that's another frustrating thing right there, just trying to get it going too soon. So in some situations, Wildcats a little slow, then that one, Wildcats Marcus Vella just a little too fast. Got to find a happy median here. All right, still time to work. 44 seconds of the main advantage.
Face off outside the UNH line. Dumped in after the draw was won by Sacred Heart, sent in by Hansen. Near side, it's Dylan Maller. 30 seconds left on the power play to Nazarian. Nazarian, he got his skate tied up with Lotito. They both go down. Nazarian is still down. And we get a whistle, and Aaron Nazarian appears to be in a great deal of pain.
Oh, yeah, it was a knee-on-knee collision. And it looked like his knee got the worst of it. Ah, you hate to see these.
We'll take a timeout while Glenn Riefenstahl, the athletic trainer, takes a look at Era. No score, 11:45 left, second period. This is Wildcat Hockey from Learfield.